Today I want to show you a lovely species of silk moth from the United States of America, the Hyalophora columbia. Now, the Hyalophora is one of the three, or actually four, if you believe the recent new changes in taxonomy, species of Hyalophora found in the United States. Now, I've also always been fond of this genus of moths. Of course, my favorite is the big Cecropia moth, the Hyalophora Cecropia. But this is the smaller cousin. And it's found in the northern United States, in North America, where it has one generation per year that hatches in spring. And the caterpillars are fond of a variety of trees. One thing they like in particular is larch tree, aka larix. But the caterpillars are also found on different types of cherries, aka prunus, such as Prunus serotina, but I think they also accept other kinds of prunus, such as Prunus padus, etc. And last but not least, they are also found on other deciduous trees, such as willow, salix, and more. I just had three individuals of this moth hatch, and you're probably wondering, so Bart, where's this third individual that we saw in the intro? Well, let's just say that it's in its cage, but it's trying to fly away. So I cannot take this moth out of the cage, because it would fly away in 1 second. These other two are calm today, so these are allowed outside for my YouTube video. All three moths here are males. So that means there is currently zero chance of having a pairing. But that's also why they appear a bit smallish, because the male is smaller than the female. This is normal for many types of silk moth. And Hyalophora columbia is no exception. It is a smaller species than the giant Cecropia though. So if you are used to seeing giant robin moths, you'll notice that this one is significantly smaller. But it's really beautiful in its own way. So we have these three males here, and I'm desperately waiting for a female. I have more cocoons. I have about 10 cocoons in total. And with some luck, if luck is on my side, which hope will happen, then I'm going to have a female they can pair with and attempt to raise the caterpillars. That would be good. I find Hyalophora a very difficult genus to breed. I'm not sure why. I struggle with them. Despite having a lot of experience with silk moths, to me they're just, I think they're my Achilles heel. Just one of those species I struggle with, and maybe I'll master them someday, but with some luck we are going to do another attempt this year. Thank you for watching, until next video.